So we all know Coca-Cola, right? A true paragon of virtue, to be sure. Nothing they produce has ever come from people being forced into slavery, and their products of water and huge amounts of sugar haven't made a huge contribution to the obesity epidemic at all, which in turn has made such a huge part of the population vulnerable to a virus that doesn't really affect people not overweight or old, so much so we had to lock down the world. No, Coca-Cola are a stand-up company, and I won't have anyone say otherwise. So imagine my surprise when I learned that Coca-Cola is forcing their staff into doing extremely racist online courses or else they lose their jobs. A brave whistleblower leaked some slides, so let's look at this craziness that some woke lunatic in some HR department dreamt up and thought it would be a great idea to put the workers through. Here's the first slide. Confronting racism. Understanding what it means to be white, challenging what it means to be racist. What? This is sounding like they just said all white people are racist, but I'm sure they weren't saying that. I'm just being silly. Maybe the next slide can clear this up a little bit. Next slide. In the US and other Western nations, white people are socialized to feel white people are inherently superior because they are white. Research shows that by age 3 or 4, children understand that it is better to be white. Oh well, I was wrong. This is telling me I'm a terrible person solely based on my skin color. And who did that research? My guess is an imagination, because I don't know if anyone remembers being 3 or 4, but I was barely able to use a knife and fork correctly and only just out of the habit of shitting my pants. I wasn't even aware of the concept of race or racial inequality. I was barely aware of concepts at all. I wasn't really sitting there watching SpongeBob planning how to form my own KKK clan, but my memories of being at age of hazy. Maybe I was a grand wizard in the Ku Klux Klan and I've just forgotten it. Next slide. Try to be less white. Again, what? I can't really. It's not really not possible for me to be less white. And I've seen the backlash when well-known individuals do blackface, so I really don't want to go down that route. Maybe that'll explain it further. Here's the next slide. To be less white is to be less oppressive, be less arrogant, be less certain, be less defensive, be less ignorant, be more humble, listen, believe. What? That doesn't make sense. Break with apathy. Again, no sense. Break with white solidarity. Now, I want you to imagine if the slide said, to be less black is to... Yeah, do you see? Would this be acceptable? Apparently it is, because this exists. And also, this is fucking racist. Not just towards white people by calling them all racist and stereotyping them all with broad generalizations. This is racist towards minorities as well. Obviously, this was written by a white woman with a worthless degree who drinks too much wine. Because this is something that demeans black people and other minorities by saying everything is white people's fault as a collective, rather than looking inward into yourself and finding what you need to solve your own problems. There's a reason why barely anyone of any race or creed takes a woke mob seriously, and it's because almost nobody believes in identity politics. Everyone is not the same because their skin is the same color, same as everyone is not the same because their sexuality happens to be the same. You're fucking lunatics. Can you imagine being a normal person having to do that course? Your eyes would be in serious pain due to having rolled them so much. Some dipshit woman got paid to create this. What a waste. Think of the good you could have done with the salary of this worthless woman if she didn't sit in her office finding things to be offended by. Fuck Coca-Cola and fuck the woke mob is what I'm trying to say. That's it for today's video. Don't forget to like and share the video and subscribe for more content like this. Thanks, bye.